Hello everyone, welcome to today's vlog and thank you for watching this and for sharing in today's worship with us. Please do remember that there are also worship at home packs available if anyone would like to receive one, or if anyone knows of anyone who would like to receive one. These are issued by the cathedral, not me, so they're really good quality. If you'd like to receive one, I'd be very great glad to get one to you. If you let me know who would like one, I'll get it delivered to them. Please let me know anyway, text, mobile, phone, landline, smoke signals, you name it, just get in touch. Okay. So let us pray. O God, make speed to save us. O Lord, make haste to help us. There shall come forth a shoot from the stock of Jesse, and a branch shall grow out of his roots. And the Spirit of the Lord shall rest upon him, the Spirit of wisdom and understanding, the Spirit of counsel and might, the Spirit of knowledge and the fear of the Lord. He shall not judge by what his eyes see, or decide by what his ears hear, but with righteousness he shall judge the poor, and decide with equity for the meek of the earth. The wolf shall dwell with the lamb, and the leopard shall lie down with the kid. Calf, the lion, and the fatling together, with a little child to lead them. They shall not hurt or destroy in all my holy mountain, for the earth shall be full of the knowledge of the Lord, as the waters cover the sea. Glory to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, as it was in the beginning, is now, and shall be for ever. Amen. That this day may be holy, good, and peaceful, let us pray with one heart and mind. As our evening prayer rises before you, O God, so may your mercy come down upon us to cleanse our hearts and set us free to sing your praise, now and forever. Amen. Song from the Book of Revelation. All nations shall come and worship you, O Christ, and share in the feast of your kingdom. Great and wonderful are your deeds, Lord God the Almighty. Just and true are your ways, O ruler of the nations. Who shall not revere and praise your holy name, O Lord? For you alone are holy. All nations shall come and worship in your presence, for your just dealings have been revealed. To the one who sits on the throne and to the Lamb, be blessing and honour and glory and might for ever and ever. Amen. All nations shall come and worship you, O Christ, and share in the feast of your kingdom. Fear not, for I have redeemed you. I have called you by name, you are mine. Fear not, for I have redeemed you. I have called you by name, you are mine. When you pass through the waters, I will be with you. When you walk through fire, you shall not be burned. I have called you by name, you are mine. Glory to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit. Fear not, for I have redeemed you. I have called you by name, you are mine. The song of the Magnificat, the song of Mary. You have filled the hungry with good things, and sent the rich away empty. My soul proclaims the greatness of the Lord. My spirit rejoices in God my Saviour. He has looked with favour on his lowly servant. From this day all generations will call me blessed. The Almighty has done great things for me, and holy is his name. He has mercy on those who fear him, from generation to generation. He has shown strength with his arm, and has scattered the proud in their conceit, casting down the mighty from their thrones and lifting up the lowly. He has filled the hungry with good things and sent the rich away empty. He has come to the aid of his servant Israel to remember his promise of mercy, the promise made to our ancestors, to Abraham and his children forever. Glory to the Father and to the Son and to the Holy Spirit, as it was in the beginning, is now and shall be forever. Amen. You have filled the hungry with good things and sent the rich away empty. O God, the source of all good desires, all right judgments and all just works. Give to your servants that peace which the world cannot give, that our hearts may be set to obey your commandments, and that, freed from the fear of our enemies, we may pass our time in rest and quietness, through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. Today's Bible reading is taken from the Gospel according to St. Luke, chapter 12, beginning to read from verse 13. A man in the crowd said to Jesus, "Teacher, tell my brother to divide with me the property our father left us." Jesus answered him, "My friend, who gave me the right to judge or to divide the property between you two?" And he went on to say to them all, "Watch out and guard yourselves from every kind of greed, because a person's true life is not made up of the things he owns, no matter how rich he may be." Then Jesus told them this parable. There was once a rich man who had land which bore good crops. He began to think of himself, "I haven't anywhere to keep my crops. What can I do? This is what I will do," he told himself. "I will tear down my barns and build bigger ones, where I will store my corn and all my other goods. Then I will say to myself, 'Lucky man, you have all the good things you need for many years. Take life easy, eat, drink, and enjoy yourself.'" But God said to him, "You fool, this very night you will have to give up your life. Then who will get all these things you have kept for yourself?" And Jesus concluded, "This is how it is with those who pile up riches for themselves, but are not rich in God's sight." This is the Gospel of the Lord. Praise to you, O Christ. I want us to think for a few moments today about prayer and about what happens when we pray and what can happen when we pray. There's a story of the first time that humans orbited the moon, the first time that any human being had left the orbit of Earth and gone out into space, the Apollo 8 mission. And one of the astronauts, Jim Lovell, I think it was, said that for the first time he could hold up his thumb and block out the entire Earth. So all he could see was his thumb. Rather, if I bring my thumb close to my eye, I can't see the screen anymore. So all of creation was blocked out by just one thumb. And the same is true on Earth as well. If we can go out into the countryside, we can see the most magnificent mountain or valley or wood or stream. All of it could be blocked out from our sight just by our thumb before our eyes. And one way of understanding prayer, and one thing prayer can do, I think, is to remove the things that's blocking our sight. Could be our thumb, could be something else, it could be all the worries and cares we have, it could be like that rich man, far too concerned about the things of this world. But whatever it is, to remove it so that we can see the glory and the majesty and the wonders of God, which lie behind all that we can see and that we're used to. Rather like if we kind of looked, for example, at the sun. It's far too bright for us to gaze at, but we could perhaps shield it by putting our hands in front of it. And prayer, one way of understanding prayer, is to begin to remove the thing that's blocking out the radiance of God's love and God's presence in our world. In other words, to move all those things of life which cloud our vision and help us to see and to feel and experience God a little bit more clearly. There's several ways of praying. In fact, there's many ways of praying. One is this way, what's called the Divine Office, which I, as a priest, have the privilege of being required to say on behalf of everyone in the parish or anyone else who'd like to be included. Another is to pray at home, either individually, to find a quiet space, a quiet time, to try and just maybe light a candle and focus and remove all of those cares which form the basis, the most of our vision, but actually block out quite a lot of what God has in store for us. And maybe to pray as a family, say grace before a meal or at other times. And I suppose for most people, the main way of praying is to come to church, which we know we've not been able to do these last couple of months. But when we take part in the liturgy of church, that is the way of joining in what the church itself has been given to help us all to move closer to God. Now, here's the thing. Most of us, in fact, if not all of us, for a lot of the time, if not most of the time, can't fully focus 100% on the words of the liturgy in church. Some of us can't focus 100% on anything most of the time anyway. And a lot of the liturgy will become familiar and sometimes, if we're honest, a little bit boring and not really addressing how we feel or how we, what our priorities are at that time. Well, one way of approaching that is to think, A, we've actually been given that liturgy. It's come down over the centuries. It's not something that we've dreamt up from our own needs. So it's there to kind of challenge us. It's there as a counterpoint to our own lives. And if we go back, the actual institution of the Eucharist was, of course, actually given by Jesus himself at the Last Supper. So it's something, if we find it unfamiliar, that's good, because it should be unfamiliar. It should be that challenge to us to remove the things before our eyes. And we shouldn't expect all the time to be 100% fully engaged, as if we were kind of eating our favourite cake or something like that. But at times, that liturgy can help remove what's in front of us, because it should be outside ourselves, it should be slightly different. But another is to think of it really as something which we're being invited to. We're actually being invited to join in something as an open door. So when we come to pray, it's like God is opening a door to us to go beyond our own cares and concerns and enter into his marvels and things that he has in store for us. Let's read this short passage today. The first step in understanding liturgical prayer is to understand it as a gift, an invitation. It's like a doorway to the limits of the life of eternity. In the liturgy, Christ comes to us exactly where we are. We should not try to hide behind an event we ourselves have made up, but let Christ do things his way, take the scales from our eyes, and reveal the true beauty hidden beneath the pots and pans of the everyday round. Marvellous words and way of understanding that's something we need outside ourselves. And as we go through life, it's a bit like maybe if we go through our holidays when we're eventually being able to take them again, and bringing back souvenirs, and we pick up something and that becomes a reminder of some memory of something in our lives. And in our prayer life, the point of all of that is to help us to realise God's love for us and to move us closer to God. And we all know, don't we, that there can be many, many objects which we have in our life, many souvenirs maybe which we bring back, memories of particular times, places or people. But none of them, I suggest, are any good unless they are things which bring us closer to the love of God. We go through life sometimes carrying around lots of these souvenirs, and sometimes we can be a little bit overburdened by them. What I would say prayer helps us to do is put those things which don't bring us into the love of God to one side, to unpack that and help us to carry around just those good things which are good for our well-being, our minds, our bodies and our own souls as well, to get rid of all those souvenirs, or at least put them to one side and don't make them the main point of our life. that don't bring us closer to God, but actually make sure that what we're carrying around, and maybe what we carry with us into heaven, is that word that the Bible speaks of as charity, which is the pure love that God has for each one of us, and to make sure that is the focus of our lives. And when we pray, that's what we're also being helped to do, to make sure that the souvenirs, the baggage we carry around with us, are the things of love. Pray to God, who has given us sure knowledge of his unchanging truth and glory. Lord, as you have founded the church on the teaching of the apostles, grant that she may faithfully hold and make known the traditions which they taught. Give to all Christian people grace in their time to follow the example of all your apostles and disciples, and all whom we commemorate in our hearts. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer. May the light of the resurrection faith shine in the world where vision is limited and hope is faint. Where races and nations fall apart in dissension, make them secure on the firm foundation of your love. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer. Keep us, our families and friends, constant in faith. Protect us from error and make us messengers of the good news to those with whom we live and work. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer. Have mercy on any who have been led astray by false doctrine, and restore them to purity of faith. Release those who, by seeking things of not your ways, have fallen into the power of evil. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer. We pray for all who are in a special need at this time, any who suffer in body, mind or spirit, those suffering through the effects of the COVID-19 virus, those who care for them, those who have lost loved ones. We pray that we may all share in the full vision of your love and glory, as we feel for ourselves your healing and wholeness in our lives. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer. We pray for the departed who kept the faith and are now at rest. May they rejoice in the fellowship of the apostles, whose teaching was their guide in this world. We pray for all who have died, that they may now live in the fullness of your light and love and glory. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer. We pray that Christ will grant us true following of all his blessed apostles. Merciful Father, accept these prayers for the sake of your Son, our Saviour Jesus Christ. Amen. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, the power and the glory, for ever and ever. Amen. And now the peace of God, which passes all understanding, keep your hearts and minds in the knowledge and love of God, and of his Son, Jesus Christ, our Lord, and the blessing of God Almighty, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit, be among you and with all whom you hold in your hearts, this day and for evermore. Amen. Thank you very much for sharing in our worship today. Please do remember to give our vlogs lots of likes, lots of thumbs up on our Fenny Church's YouTube channel, and to encourage as many people as you can to subscribe so that it boosts our presence on the internet, makes us easier to find, and keeps us together as a worshiping community. So thank you very much, and I hope you've enjoyed the service. So until tomorrow, take care and keep safe, and God bless.